Similar to ancient Greek oracles known to connect divine advice to mortals, blockchain oracles are a class of technologies that know all things from the real world and bring that information to the blockchain. Meet Brett Carter.
My name is Brett Carter. I work for O1 Labs.
O1 Labs is a contributor in the Mina ecosystem that is working on developing a new type of blockchain oracle called zkOracles. But first, oracles. What are they?
In today's reality, we're in a transition between what we call Web 2 and Web 3. And what that means is a lot of our personal lives and data still exists on the Web 2 layer. And so there's a question, how do we get that data on chain? In order for blockchains to interact with the real world, they need an interface, a way to reach into the real world and grab data and bring it on chain.
Okay, so essentially, oracles connect blockchain smart contracts with the outside world. But how do you know that the oracle is giving you the right information in the first place?
So there's alternative schemes that, for example, will take data from many oracles and sort of average it across those oracles to ensure that the accuracy of that data is preserved. In order to get this data on-chain, you essentially have to push it on-chain. There's high gas costs and transaction fees in order to do that. And you have to pay to store the data on Ethereum, which is quite expensive. The most common use case for oracles today are price feeds on Ethereum. You want to provide the price of Bitcoin to a particular smart contract. Today it's really, really expensive to operate a price feed on Ethereum. What you have to do is you have to continually be pushing the price to a smart contract and paying for storage on Ethereum, even if you don't plan to query it.
No wonder it's so expensive, not to mention wasteful. How are ZK Oracles different?
What's nice about using ZK Oracles on Mina, thanks to ZK apps, is uniquely that two-step execution model, where at first we prove off-chain that we have some piece of information, that we've performed some computation, and then we pack it up into a small proof at which point it is verified on-chain. And so that first off-chain proving step is really unique because you can run a computation locally on your machine. Perhaps, for example, in the price feed use case, you can ask an API that you trust, you can ask numerous APIs, and average the prices across each other. You can perform some really sophisticated and exciting operations off-chain, query the price as many times as you want without paying any cost. And only at which point you've received the price that you needed do you execute the on-chain portion, which is just a much more efficient architecture.
Interesting. I can see this working between home buyers and a bank to get a loan, for example.
The way that this is done today is really through like a screenshot, if you can believe it or not. And it's a really insecure process. And so because this data exists on Web 2, you can imagine maybe you'd like to use a proof of your bank balance to get a loan on chain. How would we do that? It would be really nice if you could just call your bank and say, hey, would you be willing to sign a message with some private keys and I can put this message on chain to get this loan. But in reality, your bank would never do that. This is where ZK Oracles come in. I call this the cooperation problem. Your bank's not cooperative. And the way that ZK Oracles help solve this problem is essentially by adding an additional party into, for example, a web request to your bank. Well, we call them a notary. And so what the notary is able to do is to privately, without viewing any of your information, observe these web requests in your browser, for example, and sign them on behalf of your bank, just as a notary would in person. And what that allows us to do is, with really strong guarantees, preserve the trust of that web request between you and your bank, and that chain of trust such that you could use it, for example, to get a loan in DeFi.
As simple as you made that sound, surely it's not quite that way in practice. Are there any challenges in ZK Oracles development?
Yeah, ZK Oracles is just generally, it is quite hard. One of those challenges is what I would describe as the MPC, or we call it the three-party handshake. So the way that it works is you need three parties, the client being you, the end user, the data provider perhaps being your bank or the price feed, and you need the notary to perform this little dance where they essentially all talk to each other quite quickly in order to set up your request to the data provider. And it needs to preserve the privacy of your information all the way through this really elaborate process. So a solution like this has not yet been built. And so it would really be great to have the Mina ecosystem help us test this protocol, ensure its secureness, etc. I'm really excited for the Mina community to be able to build some really interesting tools that we haven't even dreamt up yet with this.
It will definitely be exciting to see what can be built with ZK Oracles. Many developers will be able to use ZK Oracles to easily pull real-world information from websites on-chain and use that data in Mina zero-knowledge smart contracts, or what we call ZK apps. Make sure to like this video and subscribe for more information about Mina's revolutionary zero-knowledge technology. Follow us on Twitter and visit our website at minaprotocol.com. Thanks for watching!